I woke up in darkness.
So, tyrannical or transformed? Hey guys, it's Alex here. So I'm taking this week's Vantage Thoughts for the Week. And this week's encounter with Jesus is going to be Saul, also known as, spoiler alert, Paul. You might know Paul from the New Testament. So let's talk about Saul. Where are we? Jesus has died, risen again, and has ascended to heaven. He's left the disciples to set up the church, this early church that's going on. Unfortunately, not everyone is on board with it. Not everyone is keen for this. The age-old New Testament bad guys, the religious leaders, are just like, nah, bro. That, what you're chatting is not happening. It's wrong. And so there's hostility between the two parties, and it gets worse and worse. And eventually, there's a young man named Saul. See where I'm going with this? And he went around all the towns and the villages, into people's homes and the churches, and he just took men and women. And he was like, what you are doing is wrong, and I'm going to take you, put you in prison, chuck away the key, forget about it. And one day he goes up to the high priest in Jerusalem, and he's like, yo, I heard some rude dudes, some Christians over in Damascus. I want to go get them. Give me this letter, some permission slip, I'm going to go get them. And the high priest's like, cool, go for it. Sounds like a quality idea. So he's off. He takes his boys with him, out on the horses, and he's like, trip, drop, click, clop, down a road to Damascus.
So, yeah, Saul's on the road, absolutely loving it. Sun's out, guns out, and they're just cruising along. And all of a sudden, just like out of nowhere, this crazy bright light appears and just knocks, so it's so bright, knocks Saul off his horse. He's like, oops, on the floor. It's like,
I am shooketh.
Saul's on the floor. His boys are just like, what's going on? I can't see. Like, so bright. Out of the light, this voice appears. And he's like, Saul, bro, not cool. But what's your beef? Why have you got beef with me? Saul's just like, what? Like, who are you, Lord? And the voice is like, yeah, it's me, Jesus. Like, why are you persecuting me? Why are you having a go at my guys? Anyway, right, I've got a plan for you, and it's not what you think it is. Carry on to Damascus, and I'll tell you what to do from there. Saul is like blind now, can't see a thing. Like, the light disappears, back to normal. Saul's boys are like, whoa, what was that? That was crazy. Saul's like on the floor, can't see, boys, literally can't see. So Saul gets held back up and taken into Damascus with his boys. And he spends 3 days there, completely blind, didn't eat anything, didn't drink anything. While Saul is chilling in Damascus, there's another guy living there, a Christian, called Ananias. And God speaks to Ananias whilst Saul's chilling in a vision. He says to Ananias, he's like, yo, there's a guy called Saul, you probably know him, he's been a bit of a character recently. Yeah, so I've got him in Damascus, he's currently blind, and you need to go speak to him. And Ananias is like, nah, bro, no, this guy's really scary, I ain't gonna go speak to him, he's a scary bloke, might kill me and my family. God's like, nah, I've had a word with him, I've chosen him for quite an important job, and you need to start this process off. And Ananias is like, oh, fine, alright, if you say so. So Ananias goes to find Paul. Paul's just been chilling for 3 days, hasn't eaten and drunk, blind, all round bad times. Ananias is like,
hi.
Okay.
I have been filled by the Spirit, and it's time for you to be filled by the Spirit. Come and be healed. Then he puts his hand on him. What's described as scaly bits come off. So Saul's sight is restored.
Congratulations!
So yeah, Saul ends up becoming one of the most devout Christians. He ends up traveling the world proclaiming the name of Jesus all after this. And that starts off a completely other story about Saul, also known as Paul, and his missionary works, and how the word of God and the gospel got all the way up to where we are today.
So what's amazing about this story is just how powerful Christ is, and how powerful a single encounter with Jesus can be. But it also teaches us that we're never too far from God, that there's nothing that we can do or say or think or feel that will actually take us too far from God, that we will never actually be out of the reach of God and his love and his kindness and his forgiveness. There's nothing we can do. I want to encourage you, wherever you are, whatever you're going through, this lockdown is not easy for anyone. So don't feel bad about how much you are struggling. Don't compare yourself to others, because everyone's struggle is individual. But don't think either that you are too far off or too far gone or just unlovable or whatever you trick yourself with. You should know that you're never too far away from God and his love, and that he is not only capable of reaching out to you, but he wants to. And all you have to do is try and let him.